Hello, Aries. This is your general reading for the month of July. Wonders. So look at that card. There are all kinds of ideas that you have bubbling around in your head, Aries. Wonders never cease. Purity of purpose. You are laser focused on something. I like it. It's happy. It's very happy energy. And you know what? Destiny for Aries should be happy, right? At the end of the day, we always want you to be happy if you can. As much as possible. Power. Oh, you are taking your power back in a situation. I don't know whether it's a job, a relationship, day-to-day life, but it's really collecting yourself. You are the driver of your own chariot for sure. Okay. So let's take a look now. I'm going to do a 10-card Celtic, and we're going to look at the different challenges and benefits and surprises and all of those good things for the month. Okay. So let's see what we have here for Aries. Aries. Okay. First card out of the deck, Seven of Cups. You have options. I'm going to do an in-depth analysis of all the cards together when we get them down. Five of Swords energy. We have, you feel challenged. Somebody around you is not supporting you. Five of Swords is somebody who's willing to knock you down a peg if they can. We have at the, oh, you're coming into the reading. The energy that you're bringing to the reading is a King of Pentacles. So at the end of the day, Aries, you know your power. It is a feminine King of Pentacles energy. It's all about, look it, I can go anywhere. I'm a really good employee. I'm a person who knows how to earn money. I know where the value is. I know how to create value. And you have a long history of that, Aries. You are the sharp end of the spear. Give Aries a chore or something to do or a challenge, especially if they enjoy it. And you have somebody who's going to be successful in most instances. All right, Empress energy. In the recent past, you have bossed up for yourself. You are living in your beauty, in your splendor. You are in the beautiful, beautiful energy of birthing something, whether it be a creative project, whether it be happiness, choices, adventures, you have ideas. You're making manifestations out of what you most want in life. You're wishing upon a star and you're making it come true. Not everybody is supportive, we know that, but it's okay too. Now the Magician card came out, it kind of flipped around. I'm not even sure which direction it was in. The Magician card reversed when it comes to the Five of Swords. I'm going to read this two different ways. The Five of Swords energy tells me that someone is being very tricky with you. Somebody's being dishonest with you. I feel for most of you it's in a workplace environment. Some sort of situation though. Now, I'm going to put it upright overall for your energy because you're in a very magical space. You are doing a lot of creating. The Magician card is all about physician, heal thyself, Magus the healer. For many of you, the Magician card is about, you know, creating what you want, magnetizing your abundance. It's all about you have the tools to do anything you want to do, whatever your dream is, whatever star you're wishing upon at this time, you have the power to manifest what you want. Now the Sun card is in your immediate future. That's your energy. Is happiness, great happiness, Leo energy. Again, it speaks to wonderful times with children. It could be grandchildren. It's a focus on summer, enjoyment, and fun. It really speaks to the fact that you also can really see beyond the current energy, and it speaks to the fact that you are creating a new life, a new level of happiness. A relationship also, when we look at the Sun card, 1 and 9 is 2, 1 and 9 is 10. It's a new beginning and a relationship. The Emperor energy, feminine Emperor energy, that is you, Aries. You are have come into your own reading. Very powerful energy, Emperor, Empress energy right now. You have people in your life that are helping balance you. The Queen of Cups, that's Cancerian energy. People around you are very nurturing. You may have a Cancerian person around you or somebody with a strong Cancer in their chart who's sort of being motherly and supportive, and but a dear friend. I'm not seeing this as being an overly big energy of nurturing. I just feel as though you have really good support. Four of Wands, you are looking for stability, you're looking for a new home, you want a new way of living. You know, your desires are that you'll be dancing on top of that building, that you could have fun. But it is also a marriage energy, which brings stability. Buying homes, selling homes, renting homes, but it's creating that stability, four corners of the building for yourself. We look at the Chariot card. So you are masterful this month. You're taking full control of your life. You're not letting anybody else really interfere. We get the bonus energy here in the reading as the Three of the Nine of Wands. You've been working hard, and the Three of Wands. You have set your eyes on a target, and you are about to reach the target. The Three of Wands is manifestation next to the Magician card, means you have all the tools. You're willing to do the work. You have fire in your belly. So what I'm seeing here is you do have, and I'm going to, So what I see here is that somebody around you is being mysterious and dishonest with you. Somebody, you, for many of you, you feel like there's someone who's a bit after you, so to speak. The truth of the matter is, though, that they can't really reach the core of you. This person can cause you a headache, but not really anything that you just won't bypass them on. It's sort of like the most annoying person in the room comes up to you, they try to cause you trouble, and you just sort of go, excuse me, and you just move past them, and that's what I'm seeing for you. The beautiful purity of purpose, the wonders of creation, and the Power card, you know, really speaks to the fact that you, again, it underlines that Magician energy. You are manifesting at this time, Aries. Let's look at the bottom of the deck and see what's going on here. Look at that Ace of Pentacles. You are manifesting something that's going to be a new beginning in career, in money, in stability. You're giving yourself the gift of believing in yourself. The High Priestess, you have great intuition. It is guiding you in the correct direction. The Five of Pentacles does say that there is a situation from your past in which you're still healing from. Somebody didn't really tell you how they felt. They did have stronger feelings for you than you think they did. The Page of Wands says that you're doing a lot of research online, you're having fun, you're throwing caution to the winds. I think you're having a dynamic, happy summer energy, but I love the beginning, the new beginnings. And when we manifest, we shouldn't really tell too many people what we're doing. And you're very, you are manifesting. The people who care, that you know really love you, have a pretty good idea what you're doing, but the High Priestess says you're just keeping to yourself. You know, you share some of your ideas with people. People know what you're doing, but for the most part, you're just sort of staying sort of silent, very analytical. You're taking your time to move forward. You know, you're creating stability. Again, you're powerful. You're able to get what you want. If you needed to negotiate something, you'd be able to do it very powerfully with the Emperor card. You have options, Aries, and they are delightful options. Other than somebody who is ill-intended towards you, I do think that there is somebody who you feel does not want you around them. Five of Pentacles tells me it's probably work-related. The Five of Swords is one of those, you know, it's like a bad boss. That's really what it is. So let's look and see what the wisdom of the Oracle has for this reading for you. I feel like that table is really crooked. Okay, let's try this. There, okay. So let's see what the wisdom of the Oracle has for you, Aries, at this time. For the month of July, it looks like a very, very good month. You have a lot of self-awareness. You know what you want. You know the direction you're going in. And you're moving swiftly, quickly. Things that have bothered you in the past, you are going through a very strong healing phase. In your life, look at unfinished symphony. You have unfinished goals. You have things in your life that you want to accomplish, and you're setting about doing it very successfully. Orphan sometimes means that somebody has left you or somebody abandoned you in the past who was very meaningful. The unfinished symphony next to that would say that you will probably hear from that person that has left you in this sort of state of just feeling as though they didn't care about you. Again, I don't see this as current energy. I see this as past energy. The unfinished symphony card tells me that. And the truth be told, you really know the score with this person. And the truth has really helped set you free in this situation. Let's look and see what the energy is around this person who orphaned you, who hurt you. Again, we see wounds here, but man, you are a great warrior. You still have a burning question about what would have motivated them. You don't know what really motivated this person. I don't think, even though you know intellectually what motivates them, you always wonder why it is that they didn't, the fairy of naughtiness, why they couldn't be a better person to you. It's just like, I gave them everything. I don't know why they thought they always had to just go off and sort of be the bad person, you know? So that is your general reading for the month of July. Aries, thank you so much. Sending you love, send some back. Bye-bye.